So today I'm doing a little photo shoot with my mom. She's being my photographer. Say hi.
Hi.
So yeah, I'm working with Toyota and Brita, and pretty much they gave us this car right here. It's like a Toyota Corolla IM, and I gotta take pictures with it for Instagram. And then I gotta go to Mississauga and do this whole Brita thing. And then, yeah, and it's raining outside right now, so I'm gonna get soaked. And I don't know how the pictures are gonna come out. Like, I'm wearing like this light blue pants and stuff like that, so you're gonna see friggin' droplets of water on me. And there was like no other time. They said I can reschedule and get the car, so they're gonna have to work. I'm gonna have to work with what I got. So let's try this out. So I just kind of finished my whole photo shoot with Toyota thing, but with the Toyota car. But I don't think I'm feeling the pictures because it's so dead and ugly outside that I have like no life to my body, like no bronziness, nothing. So I decided that we're just gonna go to the Brita place right now, and I'm gonna take my picture here. And I, as you can see, I did an outfit change. So gotta take my picture and do some Instagram posts now. But I gotta talk to a representative first, so yeah. I'm at square one right now, and pretty much I'm here working with Brita, supporting the cause, which is providing a community in Kenya with free, not free water, fresh water. And yeah, so they pretty much have like a booth set up here, as you can see, and they're giving people like a virtual reality experience of like what's really going on in Kenya and how everything is going down. So my mom's actually doing the virtual reality experience, and it's so funny because her head just moving like this, and I'm like, what are you looking at? But she's looking at what's on the TV right here. Why is her head like that? Why is her head like that? It's so funny. But yeah, it's a super cool experience. And if you purchase a bottle, or let me show you guys. If you purchase like one of these bottles or filter systems right here, you will be helping the cause. You will be giving 1 year of clean water to someone in, I can't pronounce it, but yeah, someone in the community, in this community. Good morning, guys. So I did not get to end the vlog yesterday because I was super tired. Just came home and then I went to bed. Talking to Bay on the phone right now. Are you gonna say hello? Are you gonna say hello to everybody?
Wagwan.
Wagwan, me ass.
What up? What up? What up?
Mm-hmm. You got a what?
I got a Friday fly ass TG name. Hold on one second.
Yeah. Yeah. I just got a package. I'm gonna open it for you guys. So we got Day Bloomer, it's like a pinky. Then we got Weekender, it's like a bready orange color. And then we got this one called Nightbird, and it's like a, I don't even know, ready pink. I'm not good at explaining this shit, but yeah. So these are the colors right here. Some of them are glosses, or are they all glosses? I don't know. One's a lip stain, one's a gloss, and yeah. Not really my cup of tea colors, but whatevs.
Hey guys, so today is a new day. Today's Thursday, and guess where I'm headed yet again? Going back to Jack Astor's, and this time I'm going with Shanique, Journey to Wasteland. Yeah, so she's coming here to pick me up right now. I think that's her. Yeah, that's her right there. Shit, this one's so bright. She's in her new whip. Whippity whip, whip, whip.
Hey, Shanique.
Hi.
Look at her hair, so cute. I love it. Tutorial coming soon. This is what I got for my appetizer. This is bruschetta, it looks so good. And then Shanique got cheddar soup, right?
Yep.
Yeah. It looks okay. It looks like baby food.
It does.
And with a shot of beer, a non-alcoholic beer. Guys, I was so hungry. I already smashed my food. We got Asiago chicken bow ties with arugula, chicken, and sun-dried tomatoes. And look at this. I already ate mine. So did Shanique.
Hey guys, what's up? So today's Friday. I know I've been very choppy with this vlog lately. That's just because, I don't know, I'm just not in the vlogging spirit right now, but today I am. So I am at the dentist. Well, I'm just about to go into the dentist right now. So I went prior, I didn't record that. I went like before I went to South Africa. You guys know I already took out my wisdom teeth. Then I went in for a consultation for braces. Well, he said that was gonna be my best option, is to get braces. The process will be a lot faster. And yeah, he's like, you'll literally see results like soon. So he said I might have to break my jaw, and I'm like, what? Because he asked me if I suck my tongue. I know he asked me if I suck my thumb. I'm like, no, I don't suck my thumb, but I suck my tongue. And he's like, I'm like, how do you know? He's like, I can tell by the way your teeth are, you're like, the way your mouth is, your jaw. So yeah, he's like, because you do that, your jaw formed a certain way, and you know, you might have to break your jaw and like realign it if you want that perfect smile. But I know there's a lot of people out there who dentists say the same thing, but they didn't do it. And like, that's like my cousin, two of my cousins actually, they said that their dentist said the same thing, but they didn't go through with it, and their teeth are still amazing. He even said like, your teeth are still gonna be way better than they are now. It's just, if you want that perfect Hollywood type smile, then you know, you would go through with that process. I'm like, no, it's not happening. I'm not freaking breaking my jaw. Like, are you crazy? No, just for teeth, like straight teeth is not happening. So I'm there right now. I had to go in and get another scan done. Let me show you guys. Actually, I can show you guys. Yeah, so this is what it looks like. This is what my teeth are looking like. He said he just needs to see this just so he can get like more of an approximate of like how long the process will take, and you know, just so he can get me a better configuration of everything. So went and did that like maybe sometime this week, or was it last week? Sometime this week or last week. And yeah, so I'm at the dentist now for another consultation, and I'm also doing a cleaning, and I'm hoping from today we can get the process moving, so the next time I come back I will either be putting on my braces or getting close to putting on my braces, because I want it to be done ASAP. And I'm gonna be leaving the country again for another two months starting April 21st, so I need to get the process ASAP. So like, maybe the next time I come back, or I can get it before I leave, something like that. But yeah, something needs to happen. All right guys, so I just got out of the dentist, and guess what? I'm getting braces. Oh my gosh. So pretty much the process is gonna start in two weeks. The only thing is that, okay, I don't even know where to start. So 2 weeks I'm supposed to get the braces put on, well, the top braces and some other thing that's gonna go on the top of my mouth to like, I don't even know how to describe it, like I'm not good with this stuff, but yeah, there's something that's supposed to like push my front teeth more forward. So he said he's gonna put those two on, and then he's gonna do the bottoms like 2 weeks later, because he said to do it all at once is gonna be a lot for you. He's like, if it was just the braces we could do it all, but it's because you have that other part, you have to get used to it. The only problem is right now, holy crap, it's so windy, this car is about to freaking blow. So the only thing is that April 21st I'm going to the World Natural Hair Show in Atlanta. I will be in as I am's booth. So come check me out. I will be doing a meet and greet, and I'll also be doing a, someone will be doing a live demo on me as well. So come to the as I am booth to see me. But yeah, so I'm gonna be going there the 21st, and my appointment is on the 21st because today's the 7th, so 2 weeks later. And he's like, there's no way that we can get it, move it forward or anything like that. And he's like, if you put the upper thing in your mouth, can't remember what it's called, he's like, you might, it'll take 2 to 3 days to get used to, so you'll be talking weird. And I can't be meeting you guys and be like not knowing how to talk, you know. So that's pushing me back of when I can get my braces, because I don't think I'm gonna get the braces then, because I'm not gonna look crazy talking to you guys or trying to talk. So it might not be exactly in 2 weeks. And then the thing is that I won't be back home until like June, like mid-June or a little bit after that. So I don't know what to do, guys. I'm thinking to do it when I come back, but that's just prolonging the whole process, and I wanted to get it over and done with. Or I can go to Atlanta, go to Austin, come back here, get the braces on, and then go back to Austin. Like, it is gonna be a more of a cost, but if I want to get it out of the way and over and done with, I should, you know, get to it. Because the next time I come back here, I'm gonna be going on vacation with TG, and yeah, I'm not sure. I'm gonna talk to my family and my friends and stuff and see what they think, because I like to get a second opinion. So I already paid my 25% deposit. I honestly think that next time I go in, or the next time I go in, the next time I put it on or something, I'll pay like most of it off, because I just don't want to have that bill every time I go in, even though it's not that bad. So yeah, that's a whole nother thing, like how much it costs because of the things that I have to get because of my mouth. Remember I told you how he said, like, if you want that perfect smile or whatever, you will have to like get jaw surgery. I was like, I'm not doing that. Like, he's like, I just have to warn you, or like tell you that, you know, just in case you don't get the results that you want, I'm telling you that to get the perfect smile, you have to get jaw surgery. So I'm like, I really don't want to do that. All I really want, honestly, is to get straighter teeth, have them more aligned, and then have my bottom tooth like all the way freaking straight. Like, that's all I really, really, really care about. Like, it's this space right here is because I suck my tongue, he said. So I suck my tongue like this. And he said that because of that space, yeah, that's what's gonna be kind of, that's why he wants to push the front teeth forward, so it can like kind of come out more. I don't know, it's just so hard to explain, guys, but just know that once I get my braces on and everything, my teeth will be looking better. My treatment plan is 18 months. Yeah, it's 18 months, he said. I thought it would be like 2 to 3 years. He's like, no, like, he's like, 18 months should be good, or even less. So I was like, oh, that's not bad. Like, that's less than 2 years. Like, if everything goes well and I make my appointments on time, I wear my elastic bands if I have to wear that, and do everything like accordingly, I feel like it should be finished in that time. So I'm hoping I can get this started as soon as possible. I'm just gonna talk to my family and see what happens. I'm gonna do a whole video on my main channel about like my whole braces process and you know, getting my braces on, taking my braces off, all that stuff. So I'm gonna do like updates and stuff on my main channel. So if you guys want to follow me on there, definitely do that. I'll talk about the price and everything. The price was pretty steep. I honestly didn't shop around. I just went to my dentist since I was like 7 years old. That's where I went, because, you know, I'm really close with that dentist, not with the orthodontist, but with one of the dentists who worked there. So I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna go there because it's very close by, and I'm not trying to drive up all down the place just to go to my dentist. I can literally walk here if I wanted to. So I chose them, didn't shop around for the best price. I seen his work, pretty good. He's been doing it for 27 years, so I think I've made a good pick. It was like seven grand. Yeah, I know. I hope you guys are excited for me, because I'm excited for myself. Hey guys, what's up? So today we are at Symposium. It's like a brunch restaurant bar type of thing.
Cafe, restaurant, and lounge.
And I'm here with my girl Ruthie.
Hi.
Cam.
Hey.
And Alia.
So, yeah, I don't know, we just felt like eating. We haven't ate all day yet, and it's like 4:33 p.m. So, yeah, we got some sangrias on deck over here. Look at these cute glasses, they're so big.
It depends on the weather.
Look at Ruth's hair, it's so cute and so thick, like I love it. Ruth, you gotta show everybody your hair.
This is my hair.
No, like you gotta turn around. And look at these edges though, laid. Laid. Show the other power puff side. Oh yes.
It's really puffy.
You look like a power puff girl. And skin is flawless. So this is my appetizer. I got honey garlic and hot mixed wings with some celery and carrots. And Aaliyah got a cheese pizza. Is it yummy, Aaliyah?
Yeah.
And Cam got mussels, her favorite thing ever. All right, so Ruth is gonna try mussels for the first time ever. A mussel.
Yeah. So this, you eat this little thing in the ring.
Yeah, it's just spinach too.
This is it. I mean, it's good. I mean,
it's good?
Yeah, it's not bad.
What does it taste like though?
Like fish.
Really?
Yeah.
So I got this sesame Thai chicken wrap. It looks so freaking yummy. This is like a vegetable wrap, I think, or something like that. Or a spinach wrap. And they got the, what is it? Chipotle wrap?
California chicken.
California chicken. But they got a big bun. They thought it was a wrap. No, I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Coming out, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me, say boy. Let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and put that body on me. Come on now, follow my lead. Come on now, follow my lead. Mm-hmm. I'm in love with the shape of you. We push and pull like a magnet too. Guys, that is the tune. Like,
I know, I
that song just makes me so happy. Makes me want to turn the frick up. Rude, doesn't that song just bump?
Going by
that's Aaliyah's favorite song, right, Aaliyah?
True that.
It's Shantae's B-Day.
Do it that way.
Do whatever way you want.
B-Day girl,
Two, one. Pop something.
Pop something.
Oh, no.
Made me steal bottom.
And you can feel it, no?
And I'm good.
You didn't finish it yet. You didn't finish it. You took it forever.
Yes.
Cheers to that.
Dear Shantae, happy birthday to you.
We love you.
We love you, girl.
Wait, be careful, Azarius.
Okay.
Yo, we love you.
You are my sister.
Yeah,
good up, y'all. Good up, birthday girl. Blessings.
Yep. Woo! Yay! Ew! You're fiend.
You feed them.
Smells so good.
What's popping, yo? She's just always complaining about me and my soft ass voice. I'm a little girl, don't you see? Like, this voice is big sometimes. Okay. So here we are.
How is she a little girl when she's older than me?
So we're at Scooters for Shantae's birthday.
It's about to be lit.
Oh my god, we're
jinxed.
Lit.
What's up?
Happy birthday!
everybody. So we are downtown Toronto celebrating. Celebrating Shantae's B-Day. She doesn't know where we're going yet, but it's gonna be nice.
Okay.
And she's looking real sexy today. Real sexy. In the red with the lady shoes.
How y'all watch it so firm and nice and set gold?
And everybody's wearing heels, guys. Everybody. Everybody.
We all wearing heels?
Even Rue!
So we're gonna fuse to eat some food, y'all.
This is Farley Flex, one of the owners of Fuse. My two partners are chilling over there. These young ladies just, you can do a little spot.
Oh. Hey.
Just making sure these young ladies had a great meal. We had a jerk chicken supreme. We had a, what did you have here? A roti, pad thai,
wrap,
a blackened chicken wrap, and
Fuse chicken wings, or chicken wings with a Fuse sauce.
Alright, so if you guys want to check out a really good meal, we do what's called Caribbean soul food. We got live music, we got live DJs, we got parties, right? And beautiful ladies like these are here each and every weekend. So come check us out. Alright, once again, Farley Flex out.
Ow! Woo.